number 9 at third, number 13 at first, one gone. And here it comes. That misses the zone. Two balls and a strike. Swing and a ball popped up. Base hit and a run in to score.
Well, that was one of those high percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much higher. Just a blue pit behind third right there, and that's a really tough play for a third baseman or shortstop to get to, and the same for the left fielder. So he just found a perfect place to drop that one in right there.
Javier Baez in the box with one away as he takes one there for a ball. And the pitch. And that one fouled off.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Next offering is down low. Ball two.
It's great to get on the board in the first frame of the ball game, but here's an opportunity for them to really open things up with a couple of runners on. Let's see if they can cash in.
Beats the second out there to Muncy. That's two. Bottom of the first. Tommy Edman at the plate. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. And that one is lifted in the air. Merrifield drops steps, heads back on it. Makes the grab, tracks it down after the long run. And there's one down.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
Up the middle, sneaks through, base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Got a change up and a pretty good one, too. Outside corner, but he just got extended and put the barrel on it. Showed he has a lot of plate coverage on that swing right there.
And now it's Max Muncy. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Next pitch is outside. Next offering is fouled back. The pitch. Bounced up the middle. Reaches on the backhand, but it's through. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds at second with one gone.
Back-to-back base hits. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
And now it's Bobby Bradley. And first offering is fouled off. That one fouled off. Next offering is fouled back. Bradley waits. Just missed.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Kicks and fires. And now it's even up.
Sometimes you got to fight to get back into an at bat. Take some tough pitches, even out the count.
Marte, the lead runner at second. Muncy over at first with one away.
Five foul balls in this at bat so far, and these guys are going head to head. You can see the crowd. They're starting to get into it a little.
Here's a drive out to right center. Way back there. Look out. Gone. That's what the fans came to see. And just like that, they're out front. It's 1-0. Base is empty, one away. Here's Jack Peterson.
That is good. The right fielder.
Next pitch downstairs. And that's ball one. Next offering is fouled back. Fought off foul. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. Little slider action.
And a foul ball. One down, base is empty. And now this one's a rocket to right. Way back there. Gone. Jack Peterson bops one out. And they boost their lead. It's 4-1. It's Aaron Hicks now.
That is good. The seventh fielder.
First offering misses the mark.
Well, at this pace, he's not going to be in this game for very long. But he's got to find a way to shake it off, keep it isolated to one inning, come back out. You could throw up a bunch of zeros and save that bullpen.
And a 1-1. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Into center, Bader. As this one sized up, makes the grab. That's out number two. Here's the speedy catcher, JT Realmuto, known for his rocket arm behind the plate.
Realmuto.
On the ground, Baez handles, sends it to first, and that'll do it. New inning getting started. Now it's the second baseman, Jake Cronenworth.
For the Padres, the second baseman.
And he deals.
Cronenworth.
And a strike in there.
That was just paint on the first pitch fastball.
Next offering misses, and it's a ball to strike. The 1-1 is upstairs, and that's ball two. And fouled off. And the righty deals. And a foul ball. He stays alive. On the ground, right side. Toss to Muncy. One up, one down. And now Bader up to the plate. Singing, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls to the outfield, it is beautiful. Out there to center. Squeezes it. And there's two down. Jacob Stallings down. This guy, one of the best defensive catchers going. You talk about framing, the ability to block, catch, and throw. He is at the top of the game. First pitch, just misses.
Really good athlete. And many times we talk about, you know, the feet of infielders. This catcher as well. Really quick feet. He's able to recognize the pitch, see the trajectory, and get into a spot where he can block those balls and keep them from going to the backstop.
That one hit to right. Peterson should have this one, and that'll do it. And welcome back. Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now.
Leading up for the Diamondbacks, the third baseman,
the pitch. And first offering is fouled off.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now. Next offering is fouled back. And now he steps off the rubber. And the right-hander deals. The punch out there. Now one away. Jorge Soler up at the plate.
The left fielder. Jorge Soler.
Started after it. Tried to hold up. Now a look to first. No swing. Kenny Jansen with the call. The 1-0. And that one fouled off. and a base hit up the middle. And now the lineup turns over with one away.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Check swing of the first pitch. Look down to third. Didn't go. They say it went.
One ball, one strike.
Soler, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. And the pitch. And misses inside. Stays alive. Swing and a bouncer. To second for one, and he'll be safe at first. An outstanding hitter in Ketel Marte. Singled and scored his first time.
Ketel Marte.
Look out! And it hit him. Next up for the Diamondbacks, Max Muncy. He's already singled in this game. And the first pitch misses for ball one. First and second, two down. And a foul ball. That hits the dirt, 2-1.
He's been trying to tease the zone with that slider, but these hitters have showed patience not going outside the strike zone.
Next pitch inside, and that's ball three.
Well, knowing that this hitter's got holes in his swing, because he's got so much power, pitcher still can get a little too tight, afraid to make a mistake.
And he hits a ground ball right side. Can't glove it cleanly, but they get the out at first, and that'll do it for the inning. Set for the start of the inning. And now the right fielder, Whit Merrifield.
Leading off for the Padres, the right fielder, number 15.
Gallant, back to work.
Merrifield.
There's the strike.
0-1.
And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it. Foul ball. And the 0-2. Just missed. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. So here's the Padres DH, number nine.
Designated hitter.
This is a guy you got to keep an eye on when he digs in. Definitely been known to drop a drag bunt from time to time, and he's pretty good at it, Chris.
Yeah, and he creates a sense of urgency for the defense because of the speed, because of the ability to put down that bunt.
0-2 as he waves at that one. Now you see even sluggers from time to time try and use the bunt really as a way to beat the shift. Pulls up and it drops for a hit. Now here's Starling Marte.
Left fielder, Starling Marte.
Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field. They fired in quickly, so it's first and second with only one away.
Back-to-back singles. Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
And that one is lifted in the air. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. Both runners tagging, and they almost caught him, but he's back in time.
Now batting the first baseman, Nathaniel Lowe.
Low swings through that one as he comes to the plate for the second time today. He swings and fouls one off. Sharp grounder, that's through for a base hit. Right past his coach, headed for the plate. He'll score, and it's now a two-run game.
Picks himself up at RBI. Couldn't get any air under it, but he smoked that ball back up the middle. Timing was just perfect. Got great wood on it, and there's just no chance for the infielders with how hard he hit it.
The batter now, Javier Baez. Hicks is there for it. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. Back here at the ballpark as we go to the last of the third. And now the DH, Bobby Bradley.
The designated hitter.
The right-hander back to work. Off the mark there. And that is ball one.
Been a rough start on the mound for this guy. His third inning so important for him to get on track, turn the page, settle in, do all those things you need to do to give your team a little bit of length in this one.
Left-hand batter waits. Started to go after it. Now a look down to third, and he went around. That's ruled a swing. And a pitch. And now 2-2. Way high. In the air, left field. Marte makes the grab, and there's one away. And now Jack Peterson.
Now back. The right field. Scott Peterson.
First offering misses badly for ball one. Kicks and deals.
I got 2-1 to count.
And it's fouled away. The pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. And that one hit to first. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. Pitcher gets to the bag for the out. Aaron Hicks at the plate.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, it will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
And there's a foul ball. Yoan. And that one fouled off. Two down, nobody on. And a foul ball. The pitch. Foul ball there. Ground ball to the right side. And foul ball. Deal two. Stays alive. Bounce to the right. Low steps on the bag. Inning over. Start of the fourth. Here's the second baseman, Jake Cronenworth.
Leading off for San Diego, the second baseman.
The wind of the pitch.
Cronenworth.
In for a strike. Strike one. Righty delivers. This one popped up. Gallant settles under it. One away. Harrison Bader, the next to hit. Flied out to center in his first at bat. Center fielder,
Harrison Bader.
That one ripped left field. That's back. Up against the wall and makes the catch. Two outs, base is empty. So digging in now for San Diego, Jacob Stallings. Flied out his first time. Pitch misses inside. Ball one. Two balls, no strikes, the count. Next offering is in for a strike.
Two balls, one strike.
Next one off the plate inside. 3-1 now. Swing and a miss, and it's a full count now. Now time called at the plate. And a swing and a miss, and that's that. Back here at Chase Field, bottom four, and now it is JT Realmuto.
The catcher, JT.
Here comes a pitch.
Realmuto.
And first offering is fouled off.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
Base hit into right field. So a man on base to start the inning. Around second now as they still don't have it. Safely into third with a leadoff triple.
When you pop a ball up like that, you don't expect it to get you a knock too often, but right there, somehow he got it to drop in behind first base, and that's where no one can get to it.
Eugenio Suarez up to hit now. Swings through that one. 0-1. They say it went. Right-hander kicks, deals. Oh, and now a wild pitch. In the air, left field, down the line. And that's a foul ball. The next pitch misses, and the count is 2-2. The 2-2 now. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. So up next, Jorge Soler. Steps off, looks to third, nothing happening. On the ground, right side. Base hit and a run in to score.
Well, that started and ended pretty quickly. No messing around right there. Just a simple ground ball the other way that had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole.
Line drive, base hit. They get it in quickly. So first and second, now one out. Now time is called here. Pitching coach on his way out to the mound.
Marte.
Ketel Marte up to the plate. First pitch, not close. Soler, the lead runner out at second. Edman at first, one gone. Next pitch is popped up.
Infield fly rule, if fair.
Here's Max Muncy, that funky Muncy.
Well, the way these two teams have battled in this game, you know you need more. Got to continue to add runs if you're going to get out of here with a win.
Alex Lang will take over here. He has a great slider with tons of movement.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Not the easiest thing when you're talking about a guy that's, you know, perhaps is going to be in the rotation, or maybe a long relief guy, to not start an inning, to come into an inning with pressure on it and try to get yourself comfortable.
And a pitch. Got him. Good job of damage control right there. We go to the top of the fifth. Whit Merrifield up to the plate.
Leading off for the Padres, the right fielder, number 15.
The wide to kick the pitch.
Merrifield.
And he pumps it a strike.
Not what he's looking for there, the 0-0 count. Looks like he wants the ball down in the zone.
Next offering is foul back. 0-2 now. Pitch misses there. Now 1-2.
Really good slider. He's up there just hoping that it ends up off the plate away.
And the pitch. Got him looking. And there's one down. So the San Diego batting order turns over. Number 9 will hit next. And he lays down a bunt. And he saved it first. Starling Marte, the next up for the Padres. 1-2. And the first offering is not close. High in the air, out to right. Peterson makes the grab. Marte retired. Two away down. Manny Machado up to the plate. He's got the power, but great contact skills. One of the best contact hitters in the game. That one lifted to left. Machado out of the play. And that is that. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Stepping in, the long ball threat, Bobby Bradley.
For the Diamondback, the designated hitter, Bobby.
The wind and the pitch.
Bradley.
There's the strike. Way inside, gets out of the way. And a count 1-2. Righty to the plate. That one fouled off. And a foul ball. It's a 1-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
And a foul ball. He stays alive.
Well, he's desperately looking for that swing and miss. He's going to have to just change speeds a little bit, try to move it around, create just a little bit of illusion at the end.
The 2-2. Stays alive.
Pitcher having a pretty tough time getting that swing and miss. Third foul ball in a row.
Swing and a ball popped up. Cronenworth puts the squeeze on that one. One up, one down. And Jack Peterson stands in.
The right fielder, Jack Peterson.
And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one. Next offering is fouled back. Line drive, and that's a base hit out into center field. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. He put a great
now
swing on that ball. Took the barrel right to it. Nice extension as well. 105 exit velocity. That tells you everything you need to know about that swing.
And first offering is fouled off. They say it went.
I got to count the whole entry.
Next offering in the dirt. And the count 1-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Peterson over at first with one away. At the belt and fires. And it's even up.
2-2.
And here it comes. Slapped foul. Two two now. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. The 2-2. In the dirt. And a 3-2. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds it second with one gone.
Now batting.
First and second, one out. Now up next for Arizona, JT Realmuto.
Really good piece of hitting last time, going to the opposite field.
And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Marte moving under this one. Hauls it in for the out. Eugenio Suarez digs in now.
The third baseman, Eugenio Suarez.
Next pitch has popped up. Cronenworth makes the catch, and that'll do it. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six. Now, Nathaniel Lowe.
The first baseman, Nathaniel Lowe.
Gallon back to work. That's in there, and it's 0-1. This one lifted in the air, left field. And it's just foul. Little bouncer out in front of the plate. Realmuto to first. Now one gone in the top of the sixth. Now it's Javier Baez.
Well, on the mound, very efficient. Able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at bat.
He can't get there, and that should be extra bases. And that rolls into the corner. Into second with a double, and they've got something brewing now.
First pitch swing in, went up there with the plan to be aggressive. Nevada ripped that one down the line and kept it fair. And even when you hit it that far out front, you still have to keep your hands tight to your body so you don't hook around that baseball and put it in foul territory. And that right there was perfect.
Oh, now this ball gets down. Here comes Baez around third. He'll score easily. It's 5-3.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle. Put a pretty good swing on that one as he drove it out to deep left. Didn't quite have the right combination of launch angle and exit velocity to get it over the fence, but you're never going to be disappointed with extra bases.
Next to hit, Harrison Bader. Now fly ball to right center. Peterson sizing this one up. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's two down. Jacob Stallings now at the plate. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor. And the 1-0. Now 1-1.
I was always told it's hard to take you off the field when you play really good defense, especially at a premier position. And that's what he does.
Man on second, two down. They say it went.
1-2.
Swing and a miss, and he got him. And the Padres waste a chance. Bottom of the inning, and now it's going to be Jorge Soler.
For the Diamondbacks, no left fielder.
And he deals. Swing and a miss as he was out front. Swing and a miss. He was late. Strike two.
Spin rate's outstanding on that high fastball. Really tough to hit.
The next offering misses. Gonna count 1-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And there's one down. So the lineup flips over. Next to hit for Arizona, Tommy Edman. 1-3. That one blasted deep to right. That's back. Pulls it in on the warning track.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Here's Ketel Marte.
Marte.
And a foul ball. Right-handed reliever. And that's outside. The pitch. Out towards left center. Marte under it. And that's the inning. Top of inning number 7. Now it's the right fielder, Whit Merrifield.
Leading off for the Padres, the right fielder, number 15, Whit Merrifield.
The pitch. That's off the mark, and that's ball one. Liner, base hit.
Well, that was an important at bat in this game, so a great job there stepping up to the challenge. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Left-hand hitter waits. Kicks his swing, now an appeal to third. No swing, just held it back there. 2-0. Bunting for a hit, he pops it up. Green pulls that one down, and there's one down. Now the number two hitter, Starling Marte. Line drive, base hit. Here's Manny Machado now.
Manny Machado.
And that's in there for strike one.
Don't be surprised to ball on the ground to the corners if they come home with the baseball instead of going to first base.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he...
Double steal. Line, and that's a base hit. In to score is the runner from third, and it's a one-run game.
Big time at bat right there. Comes through, and they're back within a run. Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock.
In the air, left field. Makes the grab, and there's two out. And the batter will be the shortstop, Javier Baez.
Now back
for the fourth time tonight.
Javier Baez.
This to center field. Hicks on the move as he glides back. And that's the third out.
Ready to get it.
Back here in the desert, bottom of the seventh, Max Muncy at the dish.
Leading up for the Diamondbacks, the first baseman, Max Muncy.
The right-hander back to work. Swings through that one.
This guy's usually not one to chase pitches off the plate, but he did there. We'll see if he can tighten up his zone a little bit.
Next pitch misses, and one. And the next pitch is way outside.
You get to this part of the order, yeah, there's some pop there, but more likely there's some base hits. So very important to be patient. Let the pitcher walk you, if he will.
And a pitch. Little chopper rolls foul.
Starting to get some pretty good timing on that breaking ball, but he's going to have to stay ready for a fastball. Don't want to watch one go right by you.
Ripped on the ground a second. Over to Lowe. A great play deep in the hole. And next is the designated hitter, Bobby Bradley. Out of the bullpen for the Padres, Anthony Misevich. It's his job to keep his team in the game.
Anthony Misevich.
This one in the air right field, and that's a base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Now, no waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it on the first pitch.
With the way defenders track down balls these days, I mean, both from the infield and in the outfield, there really aren't a lot of base hits on balls hit like that. But there's always a little room back behind the first and second baseman to drop a long dart in there, and he found a way.
Runner on at first with one gone. Now batting Jordan Luplo. Late swing, fouled off. Kicks and deals. And fouled off. One run game, one out, one on. Next pitch just misses. Now 1-2. Here's a 1-2. Stays alive. Pulls that one foul. Kicks and fires. That one ripped. And that's a base hit. They fired in quickly. So it's first and second with only one away.
Really nice job of two-strike hitting and added that. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there.
Oh, now this ball is driven into the left center field gap. One run across. He's in there.
Picks himself up a couple of ribbies. Breaking ball was in a decent spot down and in, but he did a really nice job getting to it before it tied him up.
One down. And up to the plate is JT Realmuto. A new arm into the game, the righty, JT Shagwa. And his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance. Line drive, base hit. Here comes the runner. He scores, and it's 8-4.
Four hits in a row, and they're really swinging it here. A lot of hitters tell themselves, line drive over the infielder's head. That's what I'm trying to do. Just keep that approach simple. And right there, it was perfectly executed. On time with everything, and pulled it into the gap nicely.
Suarez now at the plate as he swings through strike one. And there's a base hit to left. They get it in quickly. So first and second, now one out.
They are really feeding off each other. That's five hits in a row. Got the top of the ball a little bit, but not much. That was hit pretty hard through the infield. So I think he'll be happy with that swing. Definitely generated some good bat speed.
Soler, the batter now, as he swings and misses for strike one. Realmuto over at second. Suarez over at first with one away. Next offering is fouled back. And down on strikes. And there's two away. Here's the Diamondbacks leadoff hitter, Tommy Edman. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. This one chopped on the ground, but foul. And the righty deals. And that one wrapped foul. Here's the 0-2. Ground ball right side, and that's just foul. Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. Next offering misses, and a count 1-2.
This guy's a fun guy to watch taking it bat. He just battles up there. He doesn't take a pitch off at all. Makes it so difficult on the pitchers out there. You can tell they get frustrated with how long it takes to put him away.
Two outs. Tap to first. Low takes it to the bag, out with room to spare, and that's the inning. And welcome back. And here is Jake Cronenworth.
Leading off for
the Padres in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at bat out of him right here.
First offering misses badly for ball one. Next pitch is downstairs. Next one misses, and that's ball three. And the 3-0 finds the zone.
Pick a bat right here. He did the team thing, took until he got a strike. Now he's got to go to work, shorten up that swing a little bit, do whatever it takes to get on base.
Full count pitch, he'll have to wait. Time called at the plate. Next offering is foul back. swing and a ball lifted in the air, shallow left field. Soler pulls it down.
And there's one away.
And now here's the speed threat. Outfielder Harrison Bader.
Harrison Bader.
Swings through that one. 0-1. Not even close there. And the count even 1-1. The pitch. Now a high fly ball out to left center. Hops over the wall, and that's an automatic double.
Pretty much just a textbook double into the gap, and when you can drop one in there between the outfielders, you know you're making the turn at first. Just an excellent swing.
Stallings stands in with two away as he takes a ball. Pinch hitter coming on, Kanan Smith and Jigba. He gets a chance with a runner in scoring position and one gone. Runner at second here, one gone. Bounce to the right side. The tag, and he's out. Whit Merrifield getting ready to hit.
The right fielder, Whit Merrifield.
Swing and a ball lifted to center field. Hicks makes the grab, and that is the inning. And that is that. Welcome back. Out of the bottom of the eighth. Now it's the shortstop, Ketel Marte.
The shortstop, Ketel Marte.
Back now, the pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Jason Adam.
Number 27, Jason Adam.
Here comes a pitch. Swing and a miss.
Wow. Good luck catching up to that one.
Fought off foul. Left-hand batter waits. And down on strikes he goes. Definitely not a parte for Ketel Marte.
Now batting.
Here comes
first
Max
baseman.
Muncy. He is very much your typical power hitter. I'd say he falls into the three true outcomes category.
But we've seen more and more of that lately. The ability to drive the ball to slog is getting heavily favored over any discipline or strikeout concerns.
Adam, a very difficult guy to get hits off of. It's really rare for teams to string stuff together against him.
He wins every pitch. And for a hitter, sometimes a victory is just fouling off one of his pitches. Unless he beats himself, somehow can't find it, doesn't have the control and command that day, you can pretty much forget about it.
And that one almost got him.
Well, notice they've been pitching him hard inside, and the key is if you're going to make a mistake, you got to make it off the dish. If it leaks out over the plate with this kind of power, you'll be asking for a new baseball.
And a foul ball, he stays alive.
You're always having a tough time getting a pitch by him. As a hitter, you feel pretty confident that you're seeing different pitches still able to make some type of contact.
Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. Back-to-back strikeouts.
The batter, number 40.
Two outs, bases empty. Here's a big power threat, Bobby Bradley. He's already homered here in this one. Foul ball. As a hitter, there's even more pressure to take advantage of any mistake, right?
Yeah, and you're hoping that, you know, somehow, some way, whether it's a hit by pitch, a walk, something bad happens, because outside of that, stuff is just too good to fail.
Righty delivers. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. All set to start the ninth in this one. Now at the plate, number nine.
Leading off for San Diego, the designated hitter, the string fielder. Your attention, please. Number 75.
And a pitch. That's a strike. Slap the other way, foul. The pitch. Line drive. Nice grab. Starling Marte, the next up for the Padres. Ripped to short, backhand reach, but it gets by him.
The third baseman.
And at first, here's the third baseman, Manny Machado. Next offering is down low. Ball one. Next pitch is popped up. And he makes the catch. Two down. Here's Nathaniel Lowe.
How about the first baseman, Nathaniel Lowe.
And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one.
Well, this is just par for the course these days. Huge fastballs coming out of the bullpen.
Next pitch is inside. One and one. Marte off the first with two away. Next offering is downstairs. Is just one strike away. Just misses without one.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Ripped into right field, base hit. Goes to third, in there. And now they've got runners at the corners with two outs.
How about it?
So two on with two away. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Javier Baez. And first offering is fouled off. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it. And he asks for time before the 0-2 pitch. Two on, two outs. That one missed.
One and two.
And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
But with the sixth win in a row, all of a sudden, you start to look around, up and down the lineup, to your left, to your right as a player, and you say, you know what, we're good. We may have had some tough times earlier on, but this is a good team, and you start to expect this kind of play out of yourself. We'll see if this translates into a longer winning streak than it is right now.
And our final here today, 8-4. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.